Welcome back to Let's Play the Outer Worlds Murder on Eridanos DLC. I mean, it is what we play, right? What is this? Can't remember. Murder on Eridanos, yes? Yes. Okay. Shh. Don't tell me to shush. We're going down. There's baddies down there. Let's see. Deal with the frenzied Rizzo's employees. Dr. Blossom explained that some of the workers in the lab became suddenly violent and asked that you kill or otherwise pacify them. She directed you to a terminal in the utility room that could disperse a sedative gas to knock them out if you're inclined to spare their lives. Okay. Just curious. Oh, nice. Where's the utility room? Hold on. Is the utility room up here? This doesn't have anything to do with this, does it? No. That's still sealed. As is that? My guess is the utility room. Oh. I'm not even paying attention to the little. So that's down. I don't think it's in there. I think it's down. Maybe they have multiple levels. Or it's down on the level with them, and we're gonna have to sneak in there. Guys? Where's the other one? Okay, there you are. Yeah, it looks like on our level. But the utility terminal is that way. I can't see that person. They might be on a... Well, it looks like they're over there. Alright, let's go this way. Oh! There's a lot of them. They just walked up a little bit. You can see those little indicators there. I'm waiting for them to walk away again. It's barred. Okay, we have to sneak in this way then. We can cut through other rooms to get there. Maybe that's what we should be doing. They could have told me the thing was barred. Although... Oops. I think there's somebody just sitting right there. So that we might not want to cut through any rooms. Might just want to wait. Could duck into that corridor. Whoa.
Here they come!
Bumming, don't you count at me! Happy workers!
Oh, what am I doing?
I just want to be
well done.
Your friend!
We're still alive.
Yeah, we're still alive, alright. Hopefully I don't have to kill any more. Oh, that's an arm. Okay. Cut through here. That's looks like there's two workers in there.
That's a lot more Rizzos than I ever want to see in my life.
Yeah, a lot of Rizzos. Was moving quick. Oops. Oops. All right, so that's where we want to go, in there. I don't know if they walk over here, I'm not sure. Apparently they are. Oh. How do I undo that? Wait a second. Did that happen automatically? This happened last time and I couldn't remember. What is it? Adrena time, I think they call it. Tackle time dilation. Okay, Q? Maybe I hit Q? Q is not doing anything. Hold on a second. It's saving. It's like saving endlessly. Oh, that's not what I want to do. Ah! That's what I hit. Got it. Alright. Now I lost track of what's going on. Okay, go. Is it this? We want this? Utility terminal. Welcome, employee. Memo. I think we're safe in here. New employee orientation. Utility terminal. Welcome. Insert name. We're happy to have you as the new mechanic slash custodian at insert location. It is your responsibility to ensure the your location of employee is tidy and works like a charm. Your duties include, but are not limited to, cleaning of all services, regular maintenance of all machinery, restocking employee break areas, maintenance of all electronic systems, keeping inventory of the location's operational item reserves, voluntary assistance for the lab's research as needed, maintaining thorough documentation for your possible successor. Oh, they're already getting used to, like, well, get prepared for us to get rid of you kind of thing. We know that sounds like a lot, but don't worry. Your predecessor has kept thorough documentation for your needs that you can find on this terminal. We hope you're excited to begin this most fulfilling career. And remember, whoa, it's Rizzo's. How to be a janitor. Is this the thorough documentation? Training file corrupted. Please guess how to do your job to the best of your ability. Logs. Okay, first day. I've gotten 17 requests from the lab workers that I had to respond. It also managed to find time to sweep, mop, and buff this old place. I was hoping that the employee how-to document would help with some of these machines that I've never seen before in my life. But guess what? The jerk left it completely blank. I don't want to curse, guys, because it's a demonetized video and stuff, and make it harder for people to see violating community guidelines or something, whatever. It's a little crazy. Gas hookup. I got a request from Dr. Blossom to hook up the gas lines to some canisters that are mixed with a heavy sedative for dispersal in the lower labs. Luckily, I've got enough experience cleaning all the muck that builds up in the vents to get it done in a couple of days. Still, I wonder what they're needing this for. I think they took the last of the raptodons out of the lab last week. I guess the pheromone flavoring results weren't as promising as they'd hoped. Experiment participation. Jackpot. Since I read that stupid orientation document, I've been hoping they'd ask me to volunteer for something, and here it is. I get to be a taste tester for the newest Spectrum flavor. I'm heading to the lab right after I fix the clog in the showers. So exciting. With the lab or the clog in the shower. Now, yeah, these people are, like, under some kind of control. The parasites put those little tails, or they look like tails, in people's necks. And then they're basically, like, kind of like insane versions of zombies. Alright, dispense sedative gas. Ceiling door. Sedative gas dispensing. Everything's a capital defense nowadays. Didn't you know? Oh. Empty. Well, we did it. We only had to kill three of them. I'm still going to be cautious, though. Haha. Look at that. Not dead, right? Seems like they're dead the way I can loot them. Seems dead to me, I don't know. I say kill the parasites. Leave the people. But I wouldn't doubt there's some things that come back, or they just immune, or they wake up sooner. Would not be surprised at all. Ah, I'm one short. I think we can fix that. Where's my, yeah, consumables? I need something with plus and dexterity, right? Or mind attributes? How do I take the thing? Or F? Aha! Nice. Still wouldn't get me through that other one outside.
You're a deft hand with a magpick.
Well, that milk or whatever I took helped. Otherwise, I wouldn't be able to get into it. Anything else about? Ooh, that noise. I think that's it for this room. Check out this. Product Innovation Lab. View lab notes. Trial K08 has produced moderate results. The zero-calorie sweetener produces 36% of the amount of dopamine compared to popular cigarette brands. It is possible that this is as far as we can go without introducing substances that would categorize this as a tobacco product, and we're already towing the line as it is. I'm interested in a trial with a larger set of subjects. However, our lab's resources are getting cut thanks to the new lab that's begun across the hall. Maybe we can offer it to our colleagues, quote-unquote, in the marketing lab. Show them a thing or two regarding proper science. Oh yeah, they wrote marketing, actually. Messages. There's a whole bunch. To Dr. Blossom. Subject lab resources. From department_product. Dr. Blossom, I apologize, but I wouldn't be doing the team justice if I didn't question the budget cuts this lab has seen. We've had to shelve 3 products and we're losing 2 more researchers. Honestly, whatever's being developed in the lab across the hall better be more addictive than Adrena Time. Is all to L. Blossom, subject marketing lab. From this department product again. Dr. Blossom, I apologize for our team's outburst at the product presentation. I assure you, we didn't intentionally mean to scream in terror and assume the fetal position when Spectrum Brown and its slogan were unveiled. It has to be something the marketing lab did. For law's sake, they aren't even real scientists. Subject stop immediately. From L. Blossom to department_marketing and department product. I am sending this message to both teams in the marketing and product labs. I do not know the extent of your squabbles, but they end here. If it weren't for the incredible projections Spectrum Brown shows, we'd all be out of work after that embarrassment at the presentation. I expect more from both departments. Dr. Blossom. From L. Blossom, subject, when the architect's blue blazes is going on. This is to department_allRR&DD labs employees. What in blessed corporate law is all that commotion down there? You're very good at the expletives. I don't believe the rocket fuel combination distillery mixture was scheduled for another week. Could someone please inform me as to what the racket is all about? You better have a damn good reason for interrupting my meeting with the administrator. I expect a full explanation and apology within the next 15 minutes, or people are going to start losing jobs. Wow. Certainly laid down the law there, didn't she? Jumping randomly. Okay. I thought that was a gun I could pick up. Kinda looks like something you should be able to pick up. I'm still gonna be cautious. Was that you, Parvati? I heard like a faint female noise.
Rizzo's could have helped a lot of people with all the bits they poured into this place.
Yeah. These people, for all intents and purposes, are like dead. Oh. Can't play that, can I? Okay. Ew. Well, so you should have put more resources into the pipes. Huh, look at that. Want to yell at their employees. Work faster, slaves! I heard like a voice. Like, not a voice, but like someone breathing. I didn't hear breathing. You breathing like that? You're being creepy. I guess that's a Rizzo's product. I find these knockout bars all the time. We must power it on and see what's going on. I don't think there's anyone. Like, I think it was just the one worker in here. And he's out. And or dead. I don't know. We shouldn't be. Could there be anything back here? Oh yeah, there's a couple things back here. A pneumatic piston. It's probably junk, all this stuff. Beep! Don't tell me beep. I don't want to hear beep. Whoa. Am I pressing that? Oh, I'm way down. Alright, what it is... Well, the Vermin 2, I already have that. Don't use that. Grenade launcher. 88. Got one of those. Light machine gun, Mark III. Oh, you replace this. This one needs to be repaired. Instead of repairing it, I'm gonna break it on down. Flamethrower, shotgun, and hyper. Okay. So our culprit, still kind of close, is probably the... I have like 43 pounds or kilos, whatever, of Adreno. These all weigh 0.10. This is 0.20. If I drop... Oh, wait. Let's fix that. Well, the light machine gun Mark II. I don't want the tactical shotgun either. What I wanted to do is to add the junk. Oh, okay, it gives you an amount. And I'll pick these up. I'll add to junk. That much. Actually, here. Purpleberry wine. Right. Yeah, that's good. Alright, so I'm gonna add like 200 or something close to it for junk. What else do I have a lot of? Well, these weigh a little bit more. Oh, does it not? It still weighs something when we're in junk. Oh yeah, it does. That should be good enough for now. Boop. Where'd the mock apple go? Whatever. Alright, we've been in here. Ooh. You guys see that thing? That's nasty. At least I found a joint actuator that makes me feel so much better. Ew. Well, look! There's the tail. So the rest of this thing is inside somebody? Break all the canisters. Parasite spawnling. What? I swear I'm not pressing anything. Is it like, think that, like, someone saw me? Like, I forget the mechanic, but I think when somebody sees you, you could set it up to just go into Adrena time. Alright, let's check this out. This is the Slug Lab. And not slug as in the organization. These are actual slugs. View lab notes. Available lab notes. Lab notes, our discovery. Finally finished our first set of experiments on those parasites we harvested from the infected would-be attraction animals. And the results have been... What the hell am I doing? Why am I taking this tone? Who's going to see this aside from members of the research team? I barely need mention how beyond completely phenomenal today's find has been. Not only have we discovered why Harold, the system's saddest teacup canid, had his remarkable turnaround. Frankly, I'm amazed no one realized something was awry earlier. His cage was only about as large as he was. By the way, Myers, there goes your daily adreno injections theory, you buffoon. But we've also found something that will... find me to a vice presidential position in no time. Remind me to devote a bench commemorating the Rizzo's semi-industrial exploration team for giving their lives to bring back the Eridanium gigaceous from the Holy Caves. I'll also be certain to devote an even larger bench to myself for finding the birth site of the parasites and ordering experiments to start. It's you. You're the one behind this. I've already been in talks with management about ideas for products that could utilize the parasite's joy-intensifying hormones. We're gonna need to have a talk with Dr. Blossom. It's amazing that Slug hasn't looked deeper into this. We may have to have had to cede them the land, but seemingly they haven't disturbed our research site. Well, their oversight is Rizzo's immense benefit. Great job, me. Dr. Blossom, no, not great job. Lab notes, today's incident. I'm sure some of you are still shaken by the events earlier today, but the course of science never did run smooth. The benefits of our research are easily worth the potential risks associated. Garcia would most certainly agree if she was still alive. I've talked to Administrator Ludovico about setting up some additional security measures in case of another test subject breach. In the meantime, for the love of the architect, do not infect an individual test subject with more than one parasite. The frenetic joy will have to be enough, at least for now. I'm still looking into promotional means, but I think we'll find something soon. Some Rizzo's product engineers have discussed mass-producing the parasites and placing them in some kind of beverage to evenly distribute the joy-inducing hormones. Things still seem very promising. I look forward to the day when I can leave this backwater facility behind. Dr. Blossom. Oh, what a wonderful human being, huh? Lab notes. Gas and test subjects. Blossom demanded... Who's writing this? We helped the engineering team produce a gas that would target the neural links of individuals infected by Eridanium gigaceous. Well, we did. And it was simple enough, just isolated a particular cell type only found in the parasites and produce an enzyme that should shock them temporarily into stasis. But you better believe the second it came time to tell the administrator about it, she was the one who had developed the gas, and she was the one who had been primarily working with engineering to get everything together. She takes credit for the initial finding, and even after Dr. Garcia's death, which was basically all Dr. Blossom's fault, she still somehow manages to find a way to spin things in her favor. Some of the other researchers were talking about altering the gas not to target test subjects, but to target her, and for it not to render its target unconscious, but dead. I wouldn't write this down, but I know Dr. Blossom doesn't read log entries that she didn't write. Tell you, their ideas are beginning to seem more and more appealing. Wow. Not well liked. Alright, messages. 2, Department _ Utility. Subject, cadaver removal. This is from Department _ Slug. At your earliest convenience, the Slug Lab requires your sanitation services for cadaver removal. There are 2 bodies at present in the RR&DD labs, 1 scientist and 1 test subject. Send a team to move the personnel corpse to the incinerator. After this, please send a hazard team to dispose of the test subject. For highly classified reasons, the corpse can emit certain chemical compounds that are extremely dangerous if mishandled. Please don't skimp on the protective gear. We'd hate to have to hire a separate utility team to pick up the bodies of yours. Good day. Wow. From Dr. Blossom, subject... Oh, we read this. Yeah, we read that. People are gonna lose their jobs, blah, blah, blah. What a wonderful human being. Well, we are here. Still wanna explore over here. There's like hallways. And then there's stairs that go up. And stairs that might go up here as well. It might lead to different areas that were barred off upstairs that we couldn't get to. So I look forward to checking that out. Hope you guys will come along with me. Thanks so much for watching. See you next time, guys. And always, seek adventure.